Inspired by the old school, I'm in a different class. Don't tell me I'm gas, I got Nas in a bag. All I need is one mic and I'm still at tip. When I spit, run it slick, leave it still matic. Transmission my stick, I'm automatic. Ask me when I sign, I don't autograph shit. I'm mids, that's a lie, get the polygraph, bitch. I'm a naughty on the Autobahn, they all on my drift till I'm shift. I'm about to blow like the low floors of the world trades. Kamikaze stay high like I fly two planes. I don't rap like 50 Cent, but I spit loose change. It's an inside job when I blow up my brain. Stain in my mind with these stainless lines. When I mention my name for that nameless shine, got me all on your mind. Thank me for the time, I ain't even paid rent. Motherfucker, that's fine. Hey.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free bottle of air. This video is sponsored by Life. What's going on, YouTube? It's Noxhill, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, man, y'all know what time it is. We have had a crazy album dropped by Eminem, Music to be Murdered by the B-side of the tape, man. We should have seen this coming. If you guys know, this was based off of Alfred Hitchcock's Music to be Murdered by. And he had two sides. Eminem has been predicting this the whole time. How could we have missed this, people? But anyways, the requests are coming in. You know I read each and every comment, the good, the bad, the ugly, and the troll. And there is one, apparently, that needs my full-on analysis and attention. I am talking about Tone Deaf. But before we go any further, guys, I'm going to give a quick shout-out to the song in the intro. If you guys like that, I have a brand new album, Chaos Theory. 20 tracks, blood, sweat, tears, heart, and soul that I pumped into it. If you guys like lyrical rap, doubles, triples, bars, wordplay. You want to be entertained. You want to think a little bit. You want to be challenged. And I encourage you to check out that album. The link will be below. But anyways, I don't want to waste too much time because it's Eminem. I know this one's going to be crazy. I'm just cranking through reactions. We're going to just have like a timeline. You watch like the beginning, like the first few reactions, and then like the end of this album, and we're just going to see how I look. Like the bags get deeper in my eyes. My hair starts turning gray. I won't be able to speak. I'll be babbling eventually, because that's what M does. So hopefully my brain stays intact. But this is Eminem, Tone Deaf. Step up to the plate. Let's see what you got.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Huh? What did you say? Oh.
This beat's funky.
I can't hear you. I have an ear infection and I can't finger it out. Yeah. It's my all.
Oh, man. Here we go. This is obviously going to be a shady type of track. The song is called Tone Deaf. So how does he start it off? By being tone deaf. And even when he's not rapping, he's still dropping just crazy bars. He has an ear infection. It's fucked. Ear infection, right? And then obviously, I can't finger it out. He's supposed to say figure it out. He says a C word. He drops cunt in there, fingering a C-U-N-T. The fucking scheme. The man is just crazy. And if that wasn't enough, he's got an ad lib when he's like, I need auto tune. That shit just cracked me up, man. That is just, hey, he's swinging at mumble rappers yet again. Let's bring it back and just appreciate this dude. This man is wild.
And I can't finger it out. Yeah. It's my alter ego's fault. These evil thoughts could be so dark. Cerebral palsy, three so lost.
He goes up, up, down, and the second syllable is that hard E sound. That is a crazy metric scheme to hold, and he carries that like five or six lines into the rhyme. The technical writing of this dude in delivery is second to none. Also, guys, this is my third Eminem reaction in about, I don't know, a four-hour span. I don't know how my brain's going to take this one. I'm tired as shit.
And I can't finger it out. Yeah. It's my all. To ego's fault, these evil thoughts could be so dark. Cerebral palsy, three so lost.
Oh, that's so clever. I thought it was my all. It's my alter ego's fault. My alter ego. It's Slim Shady's fault. Don't blame me, he's saying. Blame the guy next to me who is actually me. He's just my alter ego, Slim Shady.
To ego's fault, these evil thoughts could be so dark. Cerebral palsy, three so lost. I eat those.
Cerebral palsy. Three Zolofts. So Zoloft is a antidepressant, strong as shit. You take three of those, you're going to be like shaking and foaming at the mouth like you have, oh my God, cerebral palsy. Eminem just knows no boundaries, does he?
These evil thoughts could be so dark. Cerebral palsy, three Zolofts. I eat those off to Rico Suave. Look it up. Cadillac with a letter.
Rico Suave. Look it up. Wasn't there a song in the 90s, Rico Suave? The album was Mo Ritmo. Who was it? Was it, what the hell was his name? Geronimo, I want to say. I think I'm close, man, and I'm not sure. Somebody comment below. But anyways, Rico Suave. We all know the term Rico Suave, right? And then a song came out, Rico Suave. It's a bit of that sort of womanizing machismo culture that you see sometimes in Latin American cultures. So I think how M's applying that here. Obviously, Shady can be a bit of a womanizer. So he's kind of relating himself to that in that track. Well, how the hell am I supposed to follow that? That is just, so we just switched the hard E scheme to a crazy ah scheme. Look it up. Cadillac with a ladder rack in the back with a cracked axle, a backpack full of packs on a black satchel, a knapsack, and a flask full of... Oh, he's got a Cadillac. Basically, we got more like antidepressant. He's drugged up. This is kind of like a trippy sort of all over the place verse from M. I think he's representing himself being on drugs. He's got Paxil now, which is another strong antidepressant. Rack in the back with a cracked axle, a backpack full of cracked packs, axle, a black satchel, a knapsack, and a flask full of yak and Jack Daniels. Girl, let's go back. Glass full of yak, cognac, and Jack Daniels. Yeah, you know, basically you're mixing these pills with this alcohol. You mix those two. Whoo, you got a recipe for disaster, otherwise known as Shady. Pack full of packs on a black satchel, a knapsack, and a flask full of yak and Jack Daniels. Girl, let's go back to my castle. Yeah. I don't wanna hassle you, Alexandra, but my dick's an acronym because it stands for you. Oh. Wait, Alexandra. Oh, no, he didn't. No, he didn't, because an acronym stands for something, right? You break down an acronym like GOAT, greatest of all time. So his dick is like an acronym. It stands for her, but also like it's standing because he has an erection in his castle. And again, the choice of like castle and then Alexandra, and it's very random. And he wants it to be that way because it's almost like he's writing this while he's on this state of just being totally messed up on drugs. That's what he's representing here. You, Alexandra, but my dick's an acronym because it stands for you. Wait, Alexandra, who? All I know is Friday, see, I met you. What? Saturday, I probably... See, Alexandra, who? He's already forgotten who she is. There we go. I don't want to hassle you, Alexandra, but my dick's an acronym because it stands for you. Wait, Alexandra, who? All I know is Friday, I met you. What? Saturday, I'll probably forget you. Guess that's what the Molly and X do. Guess who the fuck am I laying next to? But ever since D-Nice... What the Molly and X do? Because who the fuck am I laying next to? Am I laying next to? Am I laying next to? Molly and X do. You see how he just stretches out and bends that cadence to make those words rhyme and connect with each other? That is just too damn clever how he does it. And we have more drugs. You know, Molly and X meets her on Friday, forgets her on Saturday. This whole track is kind of just there, scatterbrained at this moment. To the rescue, feel a fresh crew, been a lab rat from a... Wait, we got something. X2, but ever since D-Nice to the rescue, feel a fresh crew, been a lab... D-Nice to the rescue? He's shouting out classic hip-hop, paying homage to D-Nice. Album to the rescue, right? Fucking Molly and X2, but ever since D-Nice to the rescue, feel a fresh crew, been a lab rat from... Feel a fresh crew? Next to, but ever since D-Nice to the rescue, feel a fresh crew. Oh, feel a fresh crew. Wow. Dallas hip-hop right there. Feel a fresh crew. Man, he's going back and paying homage. That's 90s shit, boys. Guess who the fuck am I laying next to? But ever since D-Nice to the rescue, feel a fresh crew. Been a lab rat from a test tube. I'm going in like the red... Wow. Long as this gonna... I already know. This is just... Strap in, people. This is gonna be long as hell. A lab rat in a test tube, basically like you're in the lab, you're in studio. So what he's saying is that he's working all the time. He's like a lab rat. He's always in studio. He's always grinding like a test tube on a lab rat. Man, it's crazy. You feel a fresh crew, been a lab rat from a test tube. I'm going in like the red roof. Red roof in. You don't like it, eat a cocktail. I'm probably going to be moving a lot more just to keep myself awake because it's midnight. And your boy's going though. Going in. Notice how he doesn't just say in, because the Red Roof Inn has two N's in it. So I love how he holds that out to just show that N being held at in. Red Roof Inn, your boy's going in like the Red Roof Inn, I-N-N. Come on. I'm a test tube, I'm going in like the Red Roof. Red Roof Inn. You don't like it, eat a cock till your jaw breaks. Call it caught between a rock and a hard place like a Sasquatch. Eat a cock till your jaw breaks, right? Between a rock and a hard place. A rock is a hard cock, a hard place, like a hard erection going on when you're eating it. He's nasty.
in. You don't like it, eat a cock till your jaw breaks. Call it caught between a rock and a hard place. Like a Sasquatch in a crawl space, cause you're watching your heart race. Like a Scarface in a car chase, but the cops are in.
Sasquatch in a crawl space. Sasquatch, massive beast, creature. What is the name of that show where they go out and they try to find Sasquatch and they like bang sticks together and make weird noises and really think that he's out there all the time? It's a Squatch! I'm going off on a tangent. Em, you crazy, bro. But anyways, massive creature trying to fit into a small crawl space. Two extremes.
Like a Sasquatch in a crawl space, cause you're watching your heart race. Like a Scarface in a car chase, but the cops are in our case. Stuck inside of a Mario Kart race, stuck in saw blades at a stop.
Oh my god, and there it is. There is just the random scatterbrainedness. Like, talking about Scarface, you know the movie Scarface, being in a car chase, Tony Montana, in a car chase, or is it cops chasing him, or is he in an arcade? And are we actually in a car chase, or are we just playing Mario Kart? See where this is going? Next level.
A star pace, what I'm trying to say is I'm driving them all crazy.
I'm driving the mall crazy. Whenever he goes into the mall, he drives them crazy. He's driving everyone crazy. I wouldn't be surprised. There's a Mario Kart track that is in a mall, isn't there? Gotta be. Calling it. Put it down. M's a genius. Knox is a genius for breaking his shit down.
Stopping a star pace, what I'm trying to say is I'm driving them all crazy. I can't understand a word you say. I'm tuned if I think this way, I prefer to stay. I'm tuned if I won't stop even when my hair turns gray. I'm tuned if they won't stop until they cancel me.
Yeah. I see the rap. They won't stop till they cancel me. I'm tone deaf. And I love how he kind of drops down. It's almost like a whisper delivery and cadence. And when he does the tone deaf line, see how it hits the beat and lines up well with it. And he's got like a couple layers behind it. It's cool, man. It's cool. Cool little hook. Cool little hook that gets the point across.
I see the rap game, then attack the verses. Turn it to a graveyard packed with hearses. Yeah. Just like your funeral, I'm at your service. Pockets on stuff like...
Graveyard. Funeral service. I am at your service. Like, what can I do for you? I'm here at your service, sir. Also, it is a service. It's in your funeral service relating to the graveyards. Yes, he is an alien. This is verse 2. Good luck, Knox. Try to survive this one.
Turn it to a graveyard packed with hearses. Yeah. Just like your funeral, I'm at your service. Pockets on stuff like a taxidermist. Just landed in Los Angeles when it's Chick Angela and her grandmother in a tan colored van. Pull up with a handful of Zans and a
Oh, love the and rhyme. So he's coming back with another crazy condensed internal scheme. But before that, pocket stuff like a taxidermist, because what does a taxidermist do? He stuffs animals with fluff, like they're stuffed up with stuffing, but his pockets are getting big because he's rich, he's paid. Now he's in Los Angeles, so we've gone random again with Angela and her grandma with a tan and a van and something, but the band.
Angeles when it's Chick Angela and her grandmother in a tan colored van, pull up with a handful of Zans and a substantial amount of gang just to ask what my plans for the night.
Hang on a second. I think I just caught something crazy. Right, handful of Zans, right? Getting high on Zans. But also, and Gan. Just. Gan just. Gan just. Ganja. 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 Marijuana. Ganja. But he put it together. G-A-N. The just. But if you take the J-U, it's like a ja. Ganja. Ganja. Gan just.
A tan colored van, pull up with a handful of Zans and a substantial amount of gang just to ask what my plans for the night are.
Yeah,
I said
it's crazy.
Into the sleep bin for the weekend and pretend it's a five star. Yeah, a leap bin to the deep end of the pool. I can show you where the dives are. We don't even.
Right, sneaking into the sleep bin because it's a motel, pretending that it's like a five star hotel. We call it that one. Leap in, I can show you where the dives are. Like diving into the pool. He's diving into the deep end. He's saying like dive into the deep end with him, but also like he could be diving into the deep end with all these drugs that he's on and that he just got with Angela and her grandma getting high. That's a great picture, man. Who doesn't want to party with a chick and her grandma? But anyways, a dive bar as well. I can show you where the dives are. The dive bars. Nice little double casually thrown in there.
Yeah, a leap into the deep end of the pool. I can show you where the dives are. We don't even gotta drive far. I know this spot, but it's so live. But I'm trying to get some head first, like a nosedive. So many side chicks.
I just heard the little guitar picks. I went back and forth on the mix. Went like left, right, left, right, left, right. And yes, I also caught the lines getting head first, nosedive. Because like when you're diving off the diving board, right, you go in head first. But also, He wants to get some fellatio before he goes out for the night to these dive bars.
But I'm trying to get some head first, like a nosedive. So many side chicks can't decide which to slide with and which should I ditch. So when it comes to ass, bitch, I get behind like the Heimlich. Had one chick.
Hang on a second.
So when it comes, so many side chicks can't decide which to slide with and which should I ditch. So when it comes
to slide with, which should I ditch? I don't know why, but I just picture like a car like sliding and then ending up in a ditch. Might be a stretch because he didn't say anything about a car.
Ass bitch, I get behind like the Heimlich. To slide with and which should I ditch? So when it comes to ass bitch, I get behind like the Heimlich. Had one chick.
When it comes to ass, I get behind like the Heimlich. Like he's getting a behind, a piece of ass, someone's behind. But also like you get behind someone, what are you going to do? The Heimlich maneuver because they're choking.
So when it comes to ass bitch, I get behind like the Heimlich. Had one chick who liked to flip sometimes on some switch inside shit. Pushed her out the sidekick and the...
Now he's getting real dirty with it. So he likes to get behind, which means he's behind the girl. But now he's talking about a chick who likes to switch sides sometimes. So she might want to get behind him. And yeah, that's very shady.
Had one chick who liked to flip sometimes on some switch inside shit. Pushed her out the sidekick and I flipped the little white bitch off like a light switch. It's okay.
Pushed her out the sidekick, right? Pushed her out the car, the sidekick, that's one. Hang on. I want to get this right because I think that this is either a triple or a quadruple.
Shit, pushed her out the sidekick, then I flipped the little white bitch off like a light switch.
Then I flipped the little bitch off, right? Like flipping someone off, giving them the bird, like a light switch you flip on and off. All right, that's out of the way. This sidekick thing, kicking her out of the sidekick, the car, that's one. Sidekick, flip it. Makes me think of like a sidekick phone, you know, little flip screen. So he's flipping that, that's two. Sidekick. Like a front side kick or a back side kick. And I don't know why this is making me think of when he just said about the chick, you know, liking to switch sides. And we just talked about the switching sexual positions. But when you do like a side kick, like a front side kick, you're turning around. You're switching sides on the ramp, on the vert. I mean, skateboard bars, phone bars, side kick bars. Also, he's giving her side a kick. That's four. I think there's five somewhere. Just... one of you will comment. If I miss like one thing, you'll let me know, so it's all good.
It's okay not to like my shit. Everything's fine, drink your wine, bitch, and get offline with whining. This is just the rhyme, bitch.
But
ask me.
Drink your wine, bitch. But he carries it. He could have just left that, and that would have been clever, too. Like, whining, stop whining and complaining, but also drink your wine.
Everything's fine, drink your wine, bitch, and get offline with whining. This is just the rhyme, bitch. But ask me, will I stick to my guns, guns like adhesive tape? Does Bill Cosby...
Stick to your guns, you know, stick to yourself, stay true to you, but also tape, sticks to it. He also sticks to his guns, like his weapons, his artillery.
Bitch, but ask me, will I stick to my guns, guns, like adhesive tape? Does Bill Cosby sedate once he treats the cheesecake and a decent steak? You think getting rid of me's a piece of cake? I'm harder than...
Oh my God, no he didn't. Well, he just went after Bill Cosby. Obviously, Bill Cosby has quite a few allegations of sexual assault, of sedating women, and rape, and yeah. So he just went there basically saying, you know, he's going to get you cheesecake and all of that. So what he's asking is sort of a rhetorical question because he knows that the answer is going to be yes. Does Bill Cosby do these things? Yes. Am I going to do this? Yes.
Sedate once he treats the cheesecake and a decent steak. You think getting rid of me's a piece of cake? I'm harder than finding Harvey Weinstein a date. And that's why they...
Oh, and then he goes after another one in trouble for sexual allegations, Harvey Weinstein. Tough to find him a date these days.
Getting rid of me's a piece of cake. I'm harder than finding Harvey Weinstein a date. And that's why they say I got more lines than Black Friday. So save that shit for the damn library.
You guys hate me. You hate me. I thought maybe I could get like a break with Tone Deaf. I'm not getting a break. This is like the hardest one to do yet. More lines than Black Friday. Because Black Friday, you got crazy lines. Everybody wants those deals. He's got more lines that he's writing and putting out.
That's why they say I got more lines than Black Friday. So save that shit for the damn library. Yeah. You heard it.
That's very clever. So save that shh. He doesn't fully say shit. Save that shh. Because in a library, you have to shh. Keep it quiet. And then he throws in the ad-lib afterwards behind to show you that this is a clever metaphor. Look at me. I'm a genius. I know it.
Say I got more lines than Black Friday, so save that shit for the damn library. Yeah. You heard of Kris Kristofferson?
Yeah. Well, oh my god, and the lines line relates to the library because books are full of lines. He's ridiculous.
So save that shit for the damn library. Yeah. You heard of Kris Kristofferson? Yeah. Well, I'm pissed off. Paul's ask.
Oh, that's just him. Just being a dick, isn't it? You heard of Kris Kristofferson? That's an old country artist, man. Is that kind of a M being M and shady? Have you heard of him? Because, like, Kris Kristofferson, he used to box too, and he suffers from dementia and memory loss. So I think he's going there with that. Like, have you ever heard of him? Because he's never heard of himself. Maybe. Maybe. And then obviously he goes a little shady. He's piss offers. Oh, child's play.
Yeah. You heard of Kris Kristofferson? Yeah. Well, I'm pissed offerson. Oh. Paul's asking for Christmas off again. I said no, then I spit this song for him. It goes, I can't.
Paul Rosenberg is M's longtime manager. So Paul is basically asking for Christmas off, and M's like, no, because I just dropped an album before Christmas. Knox wants Christmas off. M just said, no, fuck you, Knox, get to work.
Understand a word you say. I'm tone deaf. I think this way I prefer to stay. I'm tone deaf. I won't stop even when my hair turns gray. I'm tone deaf.
That just makes me think of like a little bit of a Dre sample. That synth coming in behind.
Stay. I'm tone deaf. I won't stop even when my hair turns gray. I'm tone deaf. Cause they won't stop until they cancel me. Bitch, I can make orange rhyme with banana. Eating pork rind, sword fighting in pajamas.
Oh man, how many times has he done that? You know, the orange bill line when he first made orange rhyme. He's done it so many times since then. He went on 60 Minutes and talked about it. So he's taking that yet again, except this time he's going to make orange and banana rhyme. And what he did was he just combined the words and then he's going to make it rhyme afterwards. Crazy.
Orange rhyme with banana. Banana. Eating pork rind, sword fighting in pajamas. At the crib playing Fortnite with your grandma.
I wanted to stop before that, but then he just throws more lines. Playing Fortnite with your grandma. So we got another grandma involved. He's loving grandmas on this track. I don't know what it is. And he's sword fighting in pajamas, you know, playing make-believe sword fight like a kid. But if it's Eminem being like a big little kid, then he's sword fighting in a different way with his Willy Wonka.
Nana. Eating pork rind, sword fighting in pajamas. At the crib playing Fortnite with your grandma. But I'm more like a 4-5 with the grammar. About to show you why your 5 favorite rappers.
Oh, that was clever. I'm like a 4-5 with the grammar. Ch-ch. The ad lib. Like he's cocking the gun. Like a Colt 4-5 with the grammar. So he's like a pistol. He's like a revolver just shooting off on the grammar. I love that.
Night with your grandma, but I'm more like a 4-5 with the grammar. About to show you why your 5 favorite rappers can't touch this, but before I get the hammer, I should warn you I'm
like a 4-5 with the grammar. This could be a stretch, but I'm also thinking because numbers, right? Normally, like, if you want proper grammar, you're going to spell the number out. Like, the 4 is an F-O-U-R versus just writing the number 4. But see, since he's actually talking about a gun, the 4-5... then that is not written out as a F-O-U-R. That is the number 4 and 5. So it goes against grammar rules or proper rules. I don't think that's a stretch, actually. I think I just made that happen. Just pulling shit from the sky. Like Zeus.
About to show you why your 5 favorite rappers can't touch this. But before I get the hammer, I should warn you I'm Thor-like in this manner. Thor. But the day I lose sleep, I'm...
This isn't even fun anymore. I'm just kidding. So, with the hammer, because a gun is a hammer, then he just said Thor, right? Thor wields a hammer. That's crazy. And I think there's even more to it. Hold
on. But before I get the hammer, I should warn you I'm Thor-like in this manner. Thor. But the day I lose
sleep. Yeah, that was it. That was it. I'm Thor-like in this manner. So, in this manner, like how I carry myself, but also in this manner, like he's living in a manner now, like a massive house. Because that's how successful he is. Just a casual double thrown within that triple beforehand on a, like a, let's just call it a quadruple sandwich.
This, but before I get the hammer, I should warn you I'm Thor-like in this manner. Thor. But the day I lose sleep over you critiquing me, I ever let you cocksuckers eat it me at knee.
One more time.
Your 5 favorite rappers can't touch this, but before I get the hammer.
Yep. There was even more there. Can't touch this, but before I get the hammer. MC Hammer with the parachute pants. We talked about this in Detroit versus everybody with Royce the 5'9 and his MC Hammer shout out. MC Hammer can't touch this. These MCs can't touch this. 4 or 5 MCs playing off the Colt 4 or 5 as well. That's just next level writing.
Should warn you, I'm Thor-like in this manner. Lord. But the day I lose sleep over you critiquing me, I ever let you cocksuckers eat it me, I need to be a motherfucking pizzeria.
Ooh.
But you ain't getting no cheese from me. I went from Little Caesars.
Cheese from me, right? Oh, no, he didn't. He just said Little Caesars there towards the end. I didn't even connect that. Pizza, pizza. Ia. I think he held that out for a reason. But anyways, getting cheese, like getting money. You won't get cheese from me. You won't get money from me. Letting you eat at me, letting you get to me, but also eat at me like I'm a pizzeria because you would have to come to me and eat there. Cheese, pizza, next level.
Be a motherfucking pizzeria, but you ain't getting no cheese from me. I went from Little Caesars, BLT's, grilled cheeses, being dirt poor, filthy rich, still me, bitch.
I think he worked at Little Caesars one time. I think I read that shit somewhere. He did, didn't he?
Grilled cheeses, grilled cheeses, being dirt poured, filthy rich, still me, bitch. Like a realtor, that's real tea, bitch. At the mat, bitch. Okay.
Realtor, that's real tea, because a realtor deals in realty. But also, that's like real tea. Like, how's that? How's that tea? How's your cup of tea taste? You sipping that shit? He's real tea.
Rich, still me, bitch. Like a realtor, that's real tea, bitch. At the mat, bitch. Whole camp slit. We put out.
Ah, that's real tea, too. And he says, real talk is the ad lib. That's real talk, real capital T, real talk. Oh, Eminem, stop it.
Bitch, like a realtor, that's real tea, bitch. At the mat, bitch. Whole camp slit. We put out fire. Dre stamps it.
Whole camp's lit. You know, like a campfire getting lit. Dre stamps it. He's stamping out the fire. Also, he stamped this. Put his stamp of approval on Eminem's music and put him out.
Bitch, whole camp slit. We put out fire. Dre stamps it. With my cohorts, hit a Bogart. Yeah, got your whole squad yelling, oh God, here comes Bar.
Hit a Bogart. Hit a Bogart. Let's just throw a random word from the English dictionary out there that most people aren't even going to fucking know because I'm fucking Eminem and I do what I want. How many words can I say before this gets bumped down the algorithm in terms of cursing? So a poltergeist, Bogart. Yeah, all right. Him going back to imaginary scatterbrain land because there's that little bit of just drug influence that he wants to have the first person narration have.
With my cohorts, hit a Bogart. Yeah, got your whole squad yelling, oh God, here comes Marshall with no holds barred. Bitch, I'm a hurricane. You're a blowhard like your old broad. She full of scene.
Oh, you're a blowhard like you blow yourself up, like you're full of yourself. Hurricane, blowhard because you're just blowing and you hear him blowing into the microphone. But a hurricane is much more powerful than just someone blowing.
Marshall, with no holds barred, bitch, I'm a hurricane. You're a blowhard, like your old broad. She full of semen, like the Coast Guard. And life's been pretty good to me so far.
Full of seamen, S-E-A, space men. Because seamen, Coast Guard, they're out at sea. They're men out at sea. But also seamen, like ejaculation. She's full of it. Can I survive this?
Hard like your old broad. She full of semen like the Coast Guard. And life's been pretty good to me so far. For the most part, had a couple of runs with Popo. Caught a couple of soul charges. Got a few priors like crowbars. Which is so odd because I'm 48.
Wow. Wow. How many is that? Right. Got a few priors like a crowbar. So crowbar can use sometimes to like pry things open, like trying to get into a door, prying it. So that's prior. Got a few priors, like prior charges, prior convictions against him, which he has done. He's been in court, dealt with lawsuits and whatnot. And then he's talking about people trying to come at him, right? Come for him. He's got a few priors, like people prying into his life, trying to find out more, trying to pry at him as well.
Oh, caught a couple of soul charges. Got a few priors like crowbars. Which is so odd because I'm 48 now. That 5-0 starting to creep up on me like a patrol car. I'll be an old fart. But
oh, man. The 5-0. Police known as the 5-0. But also, he's reaching 5-0. He's reaching 50. That's creeping up on him. The police are creeping up on him like a patrol car following him. He's a convict, man. He's got bars for days.
48 now, that 5-0 starting to creep up on me like a patrol car. I'll be an old fart, but you don't want no parts, so bitch, don't start. Simmer down, compose yourself, Mozart. I ain't went nowhere, call me Coast.
Compose yourself. Mozart was a famous composer. Keep yourself composed when you're dealing with him. Simmer down with that.
No parts, a bitch, don't start. Simmer down, compose yourself, Mozart. I ain't went nowhere. Call me Coleslaw, cause I'm out for the cabbage and I'm so raw. And if time is...
Call me Coleslaw? Hold up.
Art. I ain't went nowhere. Call me Coleslaw, cause I'm out for the cabbage and I'm so raw.
Cabbage, so raw. Coleslaw! He just held out that slaw a little bit differently. Call me Coleslaw. Oh, now that I know what it is, hang on, let me break this down better.
Mozart, I ain't went nowhere. Call me Coleslaw, cause I'm out for the cabbage and I'm so raw. And if-
I'm out for the cabbage and I'm so raw. Right? Because cabbage, raw cabbage, goes into coleslaw to make coleslaw. Cabbage, also known as money, he's out for the money. He's crazy.
Mozart,
man.
I ain't went nowhere. Call me Coleslaw, cause I'm out for the cabbage and I'm so raw. And if time is money, you have no clocks. And any foe caught within close proximity is getting cold cocked. My enemies, I'm a chimney. Give me the smoke ops. And RIP the king.
Give me the smoke ops, right? Give me the smoke, like the hate, the shade, a chimney, smoking, ops, opponents. But also, you'll get cold clocked, meaning he'll just knock you out.
Proximity's getting cold cocked, my enemies.
No, not cold clocked, cold cocked. Right, cold cocking out. But also, I picture him cocking a gun at you as well.
Chimney, give me the smoke ops. And RIP the king, run. And it don't stop, and I know not what the fuck you say. I told y'all it ain't me, it's my alter ego's fault. But if y'all wanna cancel me, no problem. I'll tell you the same thing I told Paul.
One more time. One more time, because I did just totally zone out there. That is tiredness.
Cock my enemies.
No! Camera's going to die. BRB. All right, and we're back. One more time.
And RIP to King Von. And it don't stop.
RIP to King Von. Rest in peace, man. Passed away. Well, he didn't pass away. He was killed. Anyways, nice of M to pay homage yet again, like he does so much in so many tracks. Paying homage to past artists, shedding light on them, sending his fans that way. He does so much for the culture. Gotta love M, man.
And I know not what the fuck you say. I told y'all it ain't me, it's my alter ego's fault. But if y'all wanna cancel me, no problem. I'll tell you the same thing I told Paul. I can't
understand. Again, kinda how he started it all. He ends it the same way he starts it. I'm guessing this is the end. If he's got four verses, I'm done. I'm walking out of here right now. But anyways, don't blame me. Blame Slim Shady. And I'm gonna tell you like I told Paul. I'm tone deaf. One more time for the hook. Let's go.
And a word you say,
I can't believe I survived this, man.
This way I prefer to stay. I'm tone deaf. I won't stop even when my hair turns gray. I'm tone deaf. Cause they won't stop until they can't tell me. I'm tone deaf.
Man, that was a bounce. That was an absolute bounce of a ride. Just bar after bar after bar after bar after bar after bar after bar. My head hurts, guys. I don't know what more I should say here besides stay safe, be awesome. Eminem, you are Knox Hill certified. We got a lot more songs to get through. I'm going to go take some Tylenol, aspirin, or something. I got a headache. I love you guys. I have a brand new album, 20 tracks. It's out now. You want to support me, support the channel directly. I make lyrical rap as well. I love my doubles and my triples too. That link will be below. If you want to see more breakdowns of M, I got a playlist of Eminem reactions, and we got a lot more on the way. It's Knox Hill. I'm out.